front door, a mom who wore really ugly sweaters and overloved me, a brother who thought he could be a quarterback for the Eagles. You know, I thought, I'm the only one who lived this. And then something insane happened, which was everybody who started watching the show would come up and go, that's my family. You know, that's my mom. She storms down to school and she gets angry. You know, my dad parents me from his chair. So then I realized, okay, people are related. So then the next logical step was to show people from my school and my friends from school and the teachers. And I think the thing that made it different from every other show that's on was I had the video, I literally had video proof that these are real people. So at first people were surprised that, you know, Barry's real, Beverly's real, they're here today, my grandfather, my dad. But then people's minds were like ripped apart that Mr. Meller is a real guy. Or, you know, you're Miss Tarabarelli, my Spanish teacher. You know, Earl Ball, they couldn't believe these were real people. And amazingly, they related to being in this Quaker school. Even though people were now watching from around the world, everyone was saying back then, you know, we had a tradition where we'd get thrown in the showers. And my gym coach wore those weird little 80s shorts. So everyone was relating to the show. And the craziest thing was people started relating to me, which felt really weird because, you know, back then, starting in middle school, I felt like an oddball, a weirdo. That doesn't mean I didn't have friends. I had a lot of amazing friends here. Gary Ball, Andy Mursky, Dave Sirota, of course Dave Kim, like these are all characters on the show and they're real people. But I would say back in the 1980-somethings Penn Charter, there wasn't really a place for someone like me. So, you know, I would get so jealous of this kid, Steve Goodrich. He was handsome, he was so nice, he was funny, he was 7 feet tall. He went to Yale, he ended up playing on the Sixers. My experience, like, I was a kid who was picked last in gym class. You know, I went to a school that had trimesters, and back then, 2 trimesters out of 3, I had to take a sport. Who does that to a kid? You know, middle school, I kind of went under the radar, and then in 9th grade, it was like, you know, all of a sudden, our pitcher, a kid named Mike Coppola, literally went on to pitch in the major leagues. I'm batting against him, and everyone's all of a sudden take it very seriously. They're wearing sunglasses and they're screaming, and my move was, you know, I'm right field, right? I would sit crisscross applesauce. This is what I did, you know, little league. Put the mitt on my head, just chill some me time, pick some dandelions. And now, not very JV, I realized people can strategically hit the ball to right field. This had never happened before. So I would stand in right field during practices before that first game, and I would pray to God. I would be like, God, if you're real, do not let the ball come to me right now. I will do anything. I will dedicate my life to be a rabbi or a priest. I don't care. And then the first game, right field, first at bat. This is a true story. The ball crack right to right field, right at me. And this haunts my dreams. Kids, Goldberg, Goldberg! And then followed by some kid going, oh no! And I kind of like went into a weird out-of-body state, and I ran, and I just put my glove out, and I dove, and I caught the ball. It was by complete accident, and Coach McMahon said, wow, you're actually good, and put me in left field. And he said, keep this up, we're gonna go to center. So the next practice, I faked an injury and sprained my finger and was out for the season. I didn't have the nerve to tell him, it was just pure luck. And that became my move here at Penn Charter Sports. I would join the team for like 2 weeks, and then I'd come to the coach and get familiar with my skill set, and I would ghost. I would just never go back. And it was a time before iPads and phones and computers, kind of, so they weren't keeping track of me, so it just went on this way for all of high school. And I'm kind of realizing now, maybe it's because the coaches were like, fine with me not being there. Or just maybe they didn't know. But that was sports for me at Penn Charter. So then there's academics. You'd think that would be better. It was actually worse for me. So I wasn't, and similar to Steve Goodrich, the 7-foot tall kid, I was so jealous of Sanjeev Swami. He is now a pediatric infectious disease specialist in Philadelphia. This kid